What's up, guys? Jock217 here, and today I am coming at you guys with my very first tutorial video. You guys might have noticed lately that I have been speedrunning this very game a lot recently, and there's a reason for that, because it's fun. Now, for those of you who are interested in speedrunning this game, I'm gonna let you know right here, right now, there's a couple things in this game that will just happen to you, and there is nothing you can do about it. And by that, I mean there is really bad RNG that can screw you up. There are some things in this game that are just flat out RNG based, so you can't really do much about it. So you could be having a splendid run, yet some bullshit could happen and you could just die and your run will be over. So I'm letting you know right here, right now, I mean, this is going to require a bit of luck. Luck is going to have to be a bit on your side. I mean, it's not crucial that it's on your side, but it'll definitely help out, because there's some things in this game that will just screw you up. Anyways, so today I will only be doing a tutorial on beginner mode. If you're going to speedrun it on proud or critical, then you're going to have to watch somebody else's speedrun, unfortunately, because I only speedrun a beginner. So I'm also going to let you know right here, right now, some of these battles I won't be able to do with pausing, because I just simply can't do it with pausing. So some of these battles you're just going to have to pay attention to, while others I can do with pausing, so I'll be able to help you out. I will do the best I can to explain these, but like I said, it's hard for me to both speedrun and stop and explain at the same time, so I'll do the best I can to explain. And if you have any questions, feel free to let me know in the comments below, or if I missed something, or if you need to find out how to fight a certain boss, let me know. I'll be happy to help you out. Alright, without further ado, let's get started then, shall we? Alright, first things first, do not, I repeat, do not carry over your clear data if you had already beaten the game, because if you do, your run is automatically invalid, because speedrunners consider it cheating if you bring forth the items that you had from your previous file that you can use in this file now. They want a completely fresh run, so no clear data, okay? Alright, naturally we're going to pick beginner, because that's the one I'm doing. And once you click yes, start your timer. Once you click yes, start the timer. Alright, so for this first sequence, we're going to have 4 cutscene skips. And allow me to give you a piece of advice right now. Before you start your speedrun, make sure that you have already played the game a little bit, allow the game to warm up, so that way this initial loading time won't be as long. Because if you just barely turn on the game after not playing it for a while, and you just decide to start your speedrun, you'll lose like 20 seconds because the loading time in here is just ridiculous. So just some food for thought. Okay, so for this first sequence, we're going to have 4 cutscene skips. Nothing too special, just cutscene skips. Okay, here's the first cutscene. Skip it. Alright, now here's a piece of advice that'll save you around 1 to 2 seconds. Once you skip this cutscene, immediately press pause after that a couple times and skip it again. That'll save you like 1 or 2 seconds. If you see the ocean, you did it wrong. It's not crucial, but it'll definitely help you out, trust me. Alright, here's our 4th cutscene skip coming up very soon. Here it is, skip it. Alrighty then, skip the tutorial, press X. And now, we're officially playing the game. So, our main form of movement throughout this entire run is going to be cartwheels, because cartwheels are faster. So, let's go ahead and do that then. Whenever you cartwheel, you want to actually time your inputs. You don't want to just mash square, because if you mash square, sometimes Aqua just won't dodge roll and she'll just keep running. So, some food for thought. Alrighty then, viewers. So, once you get here, whenever you make your jump, you want to move Aqua towards like this pile of rocks that you see right in front of me. And once you get to the arc of your jump, you want to press attack. Just like that. See what I mean? Okay, let's do this again. So jump, cartwheel, move Aqua towards the rocks, and then boom. Just like that. You want to practically just hug this little corner right there. Just jump, attack, just like that. Okay, pretty self-explanatory. So just cartwheel, jump, move towards this corner, boom. Now, if for some reason you do it too early or you end up bonking the wall, don't try to do it again. Just jump, grab the ledge, and move on, okay? Because if you try to continuously go after it and you continuously miss, you're wasting more time. So, in all honesty, go for it once, and if you miss it, jump, grab the ledge, move on, okay? Anyways, let's go ahead and continue cartwheeling like normal. Okay, skip the cutscene. Alright, so now we're at the first shadow fight. Now, piece of advice, do not do finishers, because if you do, it'll slow you down. So what you want to do here is, you want to either attack twice and cartwheel away, or you want to attack four times and then cartwheel away. You also don't want to lock on, just so you know. How do you know whether to attack twice or to attack four times? If a Heartless is by himself and all the other Heartless are like super far away from both of you, then just attack twice and dodge roll. But if a Heartless is close enough, go ahead and go for four, because then you'll be able to kill more Heartless, because every single one of these shadows dies in two attacks. So, allow me to demonstrate. Ugh. Come on. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2. Okay, maybe locking on would be a good thing. Especially since you'll know where they are. Okay, dart wheel. 1, 2, 3, 4. Cartwheel. 1, 2. Cartwheel. 1, 2, 3, 4. Might as well finish him there. Okay. Don't do a finisher unless it's like the final Heartless. Alright, so that's how that goes. So just go ahead and cartwheel after normal. After that, just cartwheel like normal. Skip the cutscene. Alright, so here we are at the flow motion rail. At the end of the flow motion rail, you want to hammer the attack button. Because if you don't do anything and you just let Aqua move, Aqua will jump super high into the air and it'll take her forever to go back down. And it'll make you lose like 3 seconds. So instead, towards the end of the flow motion rail, you want to hammer the attack button. And make sure you hammer the attack button to where you make Aqua attack only once. If she attacks twice, you'll lose a bit of time, okay? Allow me to demonstrate. 1, 2, 3, 4. Allow me to demonstrate. Behold! Just like that. Okay, and then just cartwheel like normal after that. Pretty easy stuff. Nothing too fancy. Okay, now here we are at the Shadows 2 fight. In the previous fight, it wasn't okay to do finishers. In here, it is only okay to do finishers if all of the Heartless are like practically hugging Aqua. If they're super far away or if it's just one shadow, don't do a finisher, okay? Trust me, it's not worth it. If anything, use one finisher, two tops. But for the most part, just stick with the other strategy. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, see, like that was a good spot. See, that was actually pretty good because I killed like 5 shadows there. So that was a good time to do a finisher, but if it was just like one shadow, it wouldn't have been worth it. Okay, so now 1, 2, 3, 4, cartwheel. 1, 2, 3, 4, cartwheel. 1, 2, cartwheel. 1, 2, cartwheel. 1, 2, cartwheel. 1, 2, there we go. Just like that. So that's how the Shadows fight goes. That's the way to handle it. 1, 2, and then just go ahead and cartwheel like normal. So yeah, that's how Shadows 2 goes. That's pretty easy, just as long as you don't do finishers, you should be fine. And as long as they don't pull some bullshit like hiding in the ground. Okay, so we're gonna have 3 cutscene skips here. Now this one's gonna be just like the one with Master Yen Sid. Once you skip this cutscene, skip it again before the next screen shows up. If you see Ventus, Terra, and Aqua, you did it wrong. That'll save you like, maybe like a second or two, but trust me, every second you save will make a difference in a speedrun, trust me. Okay, just mash through this text, and then just cartwheel like normal, nothing special here. That helps me out a lot. I don't know why, it just does. Okay, so we're gonna skip this cutscene. Alright, now here's where things start to get a little fancy. What we're gonna do here is we're gonna press X 5 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, what we're gonna do here is we're gonna hold directly down and then press Blizzard while moving. Just like that. So we're gonna, because this is 10 times faster than just cartwheeling. Now, what you want to do here is that once you get in this Heartless battle, start mashing R3 or the right analog stick. Just start clicking it so you can have a straightforward view. And then towards the end of your rail, you want to attack so you can get a little extra momentum. Just like that. One, two, and then the save point tutorial is going to come up. Just press X twice to get rid of it. And then just cartwheel like normal. Okay, we're going to come over here. Jump, boom, boom, boom. And then jump up here. Jump up here. Okay. Once you're on this roof, what you want to do here is you want to cartwheel, jump towards the gear, attack it twice, fire twice, and then regular physical finisher. Cartwheel, jump, attack, attack, fire, fire, boom. You want to do the fires because it speeds up the combo. Pretty easy stuff there. Oh, one more thing. Don't try to skip the cutscene. Once you activate the gear, you can't skip it. So don't press pause. Like, you can't skip any of this, so don't try. Okay, now we have double flight. And once we mash through this text, we're just going to dodge roll directly right. Dodge. Okay. Now we're just going to go ahead and go straight. So boom, boom. Dodge roll once, double flights up, and then cartwheel up here. Okay, now while this cutscene is going, what you want to do is you want to hold left and cartwheel once, and then cartwheel to the right, and you should fall. See, just like that. All right, this gear is the same as the first one. Attack twice, fire, fire, boom. Now keep in mind, viewers, on the way here, make sure you don't get like any MP orbs, or make sure you don't accidentally use an extra fire, because if you do, it'll make this next technique a little tiny bit slower. It's not that big of a loss, but it will make it slower, so keep that in mind. You want to have your MP to a set amount. Like, you see where my MP is at right now? That's where you want it to be. That is exactly where you want it to be, okay? So keep that in mind. Alright, mash through this text. Now we're going to cartwheel over here. Okay, so open the chest. This chest contains an ether. Once we get the ether, we're going to cartwheel like downright, and then we're going to double flight to the platform above. So downright, double flight up here, and then cartwheel over here. And then once you get like about right here, what we're going to do here is we're going to double jump and then have Aqua attack herself onto the platform above. Okay, so double flight. Okay, now here's where the MP kicks in. What we're gonna do here is we're going to cartwheel towards that gear, and while we are in midair, we're going to just start spamming fire while moving and then hit the gear with the physical finisher. It's gonna take a bit of practice, but I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so we're gonna go over here, move. Oh, did I accidentally use an extra fire? I must have accidentally used an extra fire. Oh well. Well, anyway, you saw the gist of it, right? What you're supposed to do here is you're supposed to do four fires and then do a physical finisher. But I think I might have accidentally used an extra fire or something. I don't know what happened there. I mean, I had the right amount of MP. Huh, I don't know what happened there. Well, anywho. Okay, so now we have air slide. So what we're going to do here is we're going to jump, double flight, and then slide immediately. Once you press that second jump button, just air slide immediately, okay? Alright, so jump over here, slide, double flight, slide, okay? And then once you land, jump, fly, double fly, slide, and then just go ahead and go along and attack the gear like normal. You're out of MP at this point, so you can't speed it up with fires. So just attack it like normal. So anyway, that's all the gears. Most of this is just movement tech. Just ignore the Heartless, attack the gears a certain way, and you should be fine. Now it's bugging me. Did I cast an extra fire by accident? I don't know what happened. Oh well, okay, so now we have shot locks. So now what we're gonna do here is just cartwheel once, cartwheel twice, and then just let her off slide. And then just start spamming air slide and just start sliding towards the boss. Just start sliding. Just hammer it. Don't go to the save point, don't fight the Heartless, don't pick up the extra ether back there that a lot of speedrunners do, just do it. Boom. All right. Now for this fight. Unfortunately, guys, I can't really give you too much help with this fight because this fight is terribly, terribly designed and there isn't really a hardcore strategy to this. Like, I mean, a lot of speedrunners use different strategies. Some use thunder and fires. Others use fire, blizzard, fire. Some just straight up rely on Spellweaver to finish it off. I'm just going to show you what I do. And hopefully it helps you out. Because, in all honesty, what I'm doing here is it helps me out. That's what helped me out the most. It seemed more consistent for me. So, just to let you know that right now, okay? What I like to do here is I like to go for two magic-based finishers, which is the Fire and Blizzard finisher, and then make sure to use them twice, and then turn to Spellweaver and finish him off. That's what I aim for. Other than that, this fight sucks. I can't help you here, guys. Fire, fire. And I used an extra fire. That's nice. Okay, see? This is actually good RNG here because I have both a fire finisher and a blizzard finisher. That's what you want. But sometimes, regardless of how many spells you cast in succession, sometimes you'll only get one or two, and it'll just complete, like, you'll just get one blizzard finisher or one fire finisher, and it'll just completely screw you over. So, luckily, this is some good RNG here. And then just go ahead and use them, and then just fire. Okay, I'm only going to get one finisher, I can tell, because I didn't use a blizzard spell. Okay, I only got a fire finisher. Now, keep in mind, you don't want to use the fire finisher or blizzard finisher while he is orange, because if you do, you will not do a lot of damage, and it's a complete waste. So instead, just dodge his attacks and attack him when he's open so you can build up your gauge for Spellweaver, okay? Okay, I'm gonna build up Spellweaver real quick. Okay, now I got Spellweaver. Now I'm gonna get the fire finisher. Yeah, it's best to just slide away if you see him turn orange. Okay, if for some reason you don't kill him with Spellweaver, but you see him that he has low on health, if you see that he's low on health, in all honesty, spam fire. Just like that. Spam fire. When you see he's low on health, but you didn't kill him with Spellweaver, don't attack. Just spam fire. Okay, now, very crucial information here. As you can see, you can't skip the cutscene after this fight. So, do not attempt to skip the cutscene yet. Wait a little bit. Wait till he disappears. Now you can skip the cutscene. So you have to wait a little bit, okay? Okay, skip the cutscene. There's going to be four cutscene skips, by the way, just like the beginning. Skip it. Don't worry, there's no instant thing like it was in the first two. This is just straight up cutscene skips. Okay, skip the cutscene. Alright, so now we're here in the World Within. We're going to go ahead and start cartwheeling this way to the left. And then once you get to like about right here, just start running a little bit and then jump slide. In here, cartwheel in there, and there you go. You don't have to do the slide. You can just cartwheel continuously. You won't lose time. You won't lose that much time, if any at all. It's just something I like to do. It's like maybe like a half a second faster, but if you don't do it, it's not the end of the world. Okay, so now here we are in the Dwarf Woodlands. This is probably the worst platforming segment in the entire run because what we want to do here is we want to get through the whole entire area without using any mirrors except for the last one. Because if you use the mirrors, it's 10 times slower. So we're going to try to do this without using any mirrors. Now, first mission is to get to that top platform right there. There's three ways you can go about it. First, let me show you the way I do it. Okay, what we're going to do here is we're going to get on top of this rock, like at the very end. Okay, we're going to make sure Aqua's facing around there, and then we're going to jump, slide, double flight, slide, grab the ledge, there you go. Okay, that's one way, and in all honesty, to me, that's the best way because it's more consistent and you're less risky. It's less risky. However, that's not the fastest way. If you want the fastest way, allow me to show you. It's pretty much the same thing, but with a little twist. What we're going to do here is we're going to go to the same thing, edge of the rock. Edge of the rock. Make sure Aqua's facing around like that. And then we're going to jump, slide, double flight, slide, and then attack to get up there. That's like a half a second faster, a second tops, just because Aqua doesn't grab the ledge. But in all honesty, in my opinion, that half a second is not worth it. So in all honesty, just grab the ledge. Just grab the ledge. Just grab the ledge in all honesty, okay? Anywho, that is the second way, and that's the fastest way, but it's also riskier because sometimes Aqua just won't target the thing. She won't attack the barrels. She won't just do anything. It'll just go bad. Sometimes she'll even bonk the cliff and just fall. So trust me, in all honesty, it's best to just grab the ledge. Now, if you're scared to get on this rock, there is a third option. It's slower, but it is safer. So what we're going to do here is we're going to come to like about right here. We're going to jump and then grab this wooden plank and Aqua can actually stand on it. At this point, jump, slide, double flight, slide. You will make it every time. You don't have to worry about attacking. You don't have to worry about grabbing ledges. You can just stand on top of that wooden plank and grab it every time. Now, it's slower because it's actually really hard to grab that ledge. Like, you have to be at like a certain pixel just to grab it, so that's why it's slower. But if you practice this enough, and you know how to jump, and you know exactly what to do with it, this can end up being the faster route. But most speedrunners just like to stand on top of that rock and grab the ledge. But this is the safer route, and you will make it every time. Alright, so that's the first jump. Now, for the second jump, what we want to do here is we want to stand right here at the end. Now, this is where you get to witness terrible platforming if things can go wrong. This jump can go horribly wrong, so we'll see if it does. So what we're going to do here is we're going to jump, slide, double flight, slide, and then mash square. Okay, we made it that time. However, there will be a couple instances to where you will come to like the very, very edge, like where the end of Aqua's Keyblade is. So there will be times where you're on that edge and you're just standing there running in place and you can't do anything. And if you try to jump, you'll just fall. So be very careful when attempting this jump. But it is the fastest way. And in honesty, I think it's the only way too, not using the mirrors. At this point, you're pretty much golden. All we gotta do is jump, slide, double flight, and then just mash square like there's no tomorrow. Mash it like crazy. Mash it. Mash it, mash it, mash it. Like, the cartwheels you need timing, the air slide you don't. And then air slide towards the window. And then just go ahead and activate this mirror. Now, you want this to be at a certain spot. Like about right there, and then just jump back, air slide, and then just start cartwheeling up. Pretty self-explanatory at this point. Just cartwheel, cartwheel, cartwheel. Alright, so here we are at Phantom Aqua. Okay, so here we are at Phantom Aqua 1. And unfortunately, this is one of those fights that I can't do with pausing, so you're just gonna have to pay attention to what I do. I'll tell you one of three things. She's gonna start off the fight doing one of three things. She's either going to A, teleport and do a quick attack, which is what you want because that's the fastest. B, she's just gonna teleport towards you like twice and then attack you. Or C, she's gonna start laughing. You don't want her to laugh because that means she's going to do her ice spell, and it takes her forever to cast that, and if you mess it up, your fight is just like completely messed up. You'll lose like 20 to 30 seconds. You don't want that to happen. In fact, you don't want her to do the ice spell at all. Now, which attack is she going to do in the beginning? Unfortunately, that's RNG based. So, yeah. Now, as for actually attacking her, you're just going to have to pay attention to what I do, okay? Here we go. Okay, she laughed. Damn it! I forgot to mention, that can happen. For some reason, sometimes, Phantom Aqua will teleport behind you, out of nowhere, preventing you from attacking her at all, and then she's gonna end up doing that finisher. Observe. Yeah, I don't know why that happens. She just does that. I think it happens if you move a little bit too forward, because what you want to do when she laughs is, you want to double jump and then hit her with two thunders. But, I think I might have moved forward too early, and that's what caused her to do the ice spell, which is rather unfortunate. Damn it. Guard. Oh shoot. Dodge. Guard. Okay. Alright, what are you gonna do now? She should just start walking at this point, right? Okay. Alright, so here's how you want to attack her. I'll show you how to attack her, at least. What you want to do here is, you want to attack her twice and then cast a fire in the middle of your combo and then just end with a physical finisher. And then attack her again with a fire in the middle of your combo and then do a physical finisher. And then one more attack will finish her off. Let me show you what I mean. Wait, why didn't she die? She was supposed to die! You know what? Okay, I don't know why that didn't... I don't know why she didn't die there. She was supposed to die. I don't know why she didn't die there. I don't know. That was messed up. That was a terrible demonstration. Sorry, guys. You know what? I'm not gonna pause. In fact, if anything, during the Phantom Aqua fights, I'm just gonna be completely silent. Okay, we're gonna go over here. Cartwheel. That was a terrible demonstration. But luckily, I have a second chance. Okay, so for here, we're just gonna cartwheel like normal. Nothing special here. Just cartwheel past these heartless. Nothing special here. Cartwheel, 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 cartwheel. Okay, cartwheel. Oh, okay. Once we reach this fourth room and you see that mirror, we're just gonna hold directly back and press triangle. Unfortunately, I used my MP a little too much, so I'm just waiting for my MP to recharge. You want to at least have some MP left. You don't need all of it, but you just need some of it at least. It'll help. Alright, sorry about that, guys. I got interrupted. Anyways, so this second Phantom Aqua fight is exactly the same as the first one. She's either going to start off with one of the three attacks. Let's see if this one goes smoother. And one more thing, you can't skip the cutscene, so don't try. Oh my god. Ugh, I mistimed that guard. God damn it. Come on. There we go. Boom. Okay. That's what's supposed to happen. There we go. Okay, rough start to that one, but the way you saw me attack her, that's what's supposed to do. You're supposed to attack her twice, fire, and then attack, finish her off. Attack her twice, fire, attack her again and finish her off. And then attack her twice, you'll kill her. Guaranteed. Unless some bullshit happens like you saw in the first Phantom Aqua fight. Okay, now we're going to dodge roll under here. And then we're going to jump up here. Now, this is important. We're going to heal because we want to have a complete MP bar for the next fight. I mean, it's not a necessity, but it definitely helps out, trust me. You want as much MP as possible. Okay, so now we're in the illusion room, and we're gonna have some fun with Combo Master. So we're gonna dodge roll over here, and then just start having fun. Boom, boom, boom. You don't even have to move. Just hammer the X button and Aqua will go there for you. Okay, dodge roll, dodge roll, dodge roll, dodge roll. Okay, about right here. Boom, boom, boom. Have fun! Okay. There we go. Now, you can do it for this third one. 3, 4. Okay, so boom, boom. Make sure you're not too close to the pipe when you do it, though. Or, like, not too far away from it. Because if you do, then, you will go into the darkness by accident. You don't want that. It's completely obvious you don't want that. Alright, so anyway. Alright, so now for the third Phantom Aqua fight. This one isn't as RNG-based as the first one, but it is still RNG-based, so this one is going to require a bit of technique. The main strategy here is get Spellweaver out and attack her with Spellweaver as much as possible. And at the end of your Spellweaver combo, hit her with fire, or at least do your best to hit her with fire, so that way you can continue doing more hits, okay? Other than that, I can't pause here, so here goes. Okay, see, that's the problem. I don't know how speedrunners do it, but at the end of your Spellweaver finisher, you're supposed to hit her with fire, but that requires, like, precise timing, like, completely precise timing, and if you miss, she'll teleport and attack you, and it'll slow you down. I don't know how speedrunners do it. I've landed it a few times, but it is very, very hard. There we go. In all honesty, just stick with physical attacks for now. And if you're close enough, you can still hit her with a physical attack. Boom! There we go. Just like that. There's your Phantom Aqua fight. In fact, that was actually the smoothest Phantom Aqua fight I've ever had. She didn't do the finishers or nothing. Did I just discover a new way to loop her? Well, anyway, pay attention to that fight. Maybe it'll help you out. Alright, so anyway, now we're just going to go ahead and dodge roll out of here. Now, once you get to about maybe like right here between the fish and the goat or whatever that is. Is that a goat? Yeah, it's a goat. Once we get to like about right here, we're going to go ahead and blizzard and ride the rail just like we did in Castletown. Just like that. Pretty easy. Now, sometimes you'll shoot it a little too far to the right or to the left, but, you know, if you do, it's not the end of the world. Okay, go ahead and go to the mirror. Alright. Alright, so now we're going to have a cutscene skip here. Just go ahead and skip it. Alright, so now, first step, we're going to run towards this save point and then cast Thunder to get rid of that first vine. And once we're filled up on MP, we're going to dodge roll, fire while moving, thunder while moving, and then dodge roll, and then just go ahead and ride the vine. Jump, air slide, there you go. Dodge roll, slide away, just try to move as fast as you can. Okay, jump, slide, double flight, slide. Okay, alright, fire while moving, dodge roll, fire while moving, dodge roll, or air slide. I wanted to dodge roll. Okay, air slide through that, and then ride this rail, attack at the end. Okay, so here we are at Dark Side. Now, I'll tell you this right now, this fight is complete garbage, and let me tell you why. You remember in the first Kingdom Hearts game where you can attack both of his hands and his head whenever you wanted to for the rest of the battle? Well, Square Enix decided to be a dick and change that. Now, they made it to where in the beginning of the fight, you can only attack his hands, and then later on in the fight, you can only attack his head. This is messed up because we want to attack him with shot locks. So, you'll see what I mean. I'm actually able to pause during this fight, so I'll show you what I mean. Okay, so fire, blizzard, attack, guard. You were supposed to guard, Aqua. Now I have to restart this fight because you didn't guard. Nice going. See you there, guys. I'll see you in a bit. Alright, let's try this again. Will you please guard this time, Aqua? Okay, so fire, blizzard, attack, guard, counter. There we go. What? All I'm doing here is just building up my command gauge to where I get both magic finishers just like that. Now, once you get your magic finishers, you want to slide away in front of Darkseid. And once you slide in front of Darkseid, you're going to go ahead and just use them both. Use it. Use it. Okay, now after you use your second finisher, you want to shot lock his hands and make sure you unleash like 10 to 12 shots. Ah. Okay, I got a little bit too much there, but that's fine. Alright, now, after this shot lock, here's something that most speedrunners do and somehow pull off. After this shot lock, they like to go for a maxed out shot lock and then just continue bombarding him with damage. Me, I don't like doing that because every single time I try to hit him with a maxed out shot lock, the target changes from his hands to his head, and since I targeted his hands with the shot lock is just completely wasted. So, here's my advice. If the target is not on his head yet, just go towards his hands and just start attacking it. But luckily for me, it is on his head. So since it's on his head, now we can do a full shot lock. If the target is not on his head, just go and attack his hands until it is. And one more thing about the shot locks, you want to get all excellence. You don't want to get any goods. If you get a good, it's not the end of the world, but you want to get all excellence because you do more damage that way. And then after this shot lock, target him and spam fire. Target him and spam fire, not target the shadows. Just spam fire because it's the fastest spell, and boom, you'll kill him. There's Darkseid. Yeah, those shadows can be a nuisance. Now, luckily for me, I'm actually out of MP right now. This is where I want to be. But if you still had MP left after the Darkseid fight, you want to heal and get rid of it because you have a full MP bar for this next fight. Okay? You can't skip this, so don't try. Okay, so cartwheel, 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 jump, slide, double point, slide. 1, 2, 3, jump, air slide. Do not cartwheel 4 times. Alright, this one's nothing special, just jump. Just go through it like you normally would. You don't really have much of a choice. Just go through this section like you normally would. There's nothing special here. Jump. Jump, air slide. Alright, see, now here you want to have a full MP bar, okay? If you're short a little bit of MP, you'll be in trouble. Alright, so here's the forest fight. Here is what I do. I like to use Blizzard while running to freeze the enemies, and then I thunder, and then I fire. If I do everything correctly, you should get all 3 magic-based finishers, all 3 of them. But sometimes, some shit will happen and you'll only get 2. If that's the case, just spam thunder until everybody dies or until you kill them, so... Let's see, but if I do my strategy correctly, I shouldn't have to worry about it. Blizzard, thunder, fire, blizzard. Okay, see, this is what I'm talking about. I was supposed to get all 3 magic-based finishers, but I didn't get them. I only got 2. So this may be a problem. Fire-based finisher, thunder-based finisher, and that guy wants to be a dick. Okay, yeah, screw you. Luckily, you're weak to fire. Can somebody explain to me why water-based guys are weak to fire in Kingdom Hearts? Just, why is that? Demix is weak to fire. Those water-based Heartless are weak to fire. Like, what the hell is that? Anyway, you want to get this chest right here. And at this point, you should have 2 ethers at this point. If you do not have 2 ethers at this point, you messed up. So, now, we're just going to go ahead and go through the Forest of Thorns. Yeah, that forest fight, if I had all 3 magic-based finishers, I would have killed them all with all 3 magic-based finishers. But since I only got 2 and kind of got screwed over by the RNG there, I had to improvise. So the main goal of that fight is you want to kill them with all three magic-based finishers. Okay, boom, double flight, slide, okay, jump, okay, slide. All right, so now I'm just gonna go down here, thunder your way across, thunder your way across, go ahead and air slide or get as much momentum as you can, thunder this last batch of vines, heal up, because we need a full MP bar for this next fight. Oh, I really hope the game audio isn't too loud either. If the game audio is too loud, I apologize, guys. It shouldn't be, though. I lowered it. I mean, it's at its lowest point. If I turn it down any lower, it's mute. Alright, anyway, so here we are at Darkside 2. Okay, so this first section, just cartwheel through. Try your best not to get hit. If you get hit like that, it's not that big of a deal, but you will lose some time. But it's not that much. Just try your best not to get hit. Okay, now, once you hear that little zzzz at the background, you hear that little barrier, immediately, shot lock. To the max. To the max, just go ahead and shot lock. Make sure to get excellence. Okay, I got a good that time. Okay, now at this point, once you're done with this shot lock, you want to just go ahead and bombard him with fire and blizzard spells. Make sure to alternate between them, because you want to get both the fire finisher and the blizzard finisher, okay? Okay, so fire, blizzard, okay. Okay, now, you see how I'm about to run out of MP? Do not let yourself run out of MP. And, oh shoot, I think I got a little peek of Aqua's ass there, nice. Anywho, you do not want to run out of MP. This is where your first ether comes in. You're going to use your first ether. Okay. Okay. Okay, now we're going to go ahead and use the fire finisher, and then we're going to go ahead and use the ice finisher, and then after the ice finisher, shot lock all the way. Okay, and then target him, and then fire, fire, blizzard. Do as many spells as you can, and then charge up your command gauge as fast as possible. Shoot, go, 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 go. Kill him, kill him, kill him. Damn it, I missed it. Ah. Damn it! I was so close. Okay, see, this last part's hard. It's that very last part after that shot lock. You have to do as much damage as possible, get your magic-based commands as high as possible, and then use them both to finish them off, but I barely missed it. So instead, unfortunately, you can't target him here. You're just gonna have to let this DM ride. You do not want this to happen. Okay, look at how close I was, too. Come on. Look at how close I was. Yeah, what you were supposed to do was you were supposed to build up your magic commands as fast as possible after that shot lock, so that way you could kill him with the magic finishers. But I guess I was a tiny bit too slow, huh? Too slow. Alright, now for the next fight. And yes, make sure to go to the save point and fill up everything, because you need it. Alrighty, and we're going to have two cutscene skips here. Alright guys, here we are in the next fight. Unfortunately, this fight's exactly like the first fight, except he has an extra bar of HP, and you have Mickey. Pretty much the same strat as the first fight. Any advice I give, don't use magic-based finishers on, him while he's orange. And, don't use Mickey's Wayfinder finish if he's orange. Other than that, may your heart be your guiding key, because this fight sucks balls. And also really bad RNG as well, thanks. God, really, really bad RNG here. I'm only getting one magic base finisher when I want to. There we go. Luckily, that Wayfinder finisher does a ton of damage. You want that. Oh yeah, also, use your second ether here. You want to hit him with as much magic spells as possible. There you go. And here, you want to hit him with as much magic as possible, so you're going to use your second ether here. Yeah, the two ethers are for Darkseid and this guy. Alright, so here, you just want to waste your MP. You can use a Blizzard Rail if you want. You want to waste your MP here because you want a full MP bar. So, if you don't have a full MP bar, waste it. Waste it and let it recharge. Okay, I'm going to dodge roll over here on this side now. Jump, slide. Dodge, 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 dodge. Okay, very important, pick up this chest. It's a Mega Ether, trust me, it's going to really come in handy, trust me. You're going to need it. Dodge roll, dodge roll, dodge roll. Just go ahead and dodge roll like normal. Again, this is only for beginner. If you're doing this on critical, watch Biscuit's, speedrun. He currently has the world record in beating this game on critical. Now, as for, who has the better time, in a beginner, it's safe for me to say that I have a better time than him right now. I'm sure he can beat me later. Anywho, because Biscuit only cares about critical more than beginner anyway. Anyway, once you get this chest, which is an elixir, by the way, you do want to get that. You have one of two options. You can either A, you can cartwheel towards it, towards the exit while staying on top of the rocks. Or if you want to, don't be afraid. You can just cartwheel away from the chest right here and then just cast Blizzard if you wanted to. But, in all honesty, I think it's a tiny bit faster, just a tad bit faster if you just cartwheel against the, rocks, because if you Blizzard Rail, you can end up going too far to the right. So, there's that. But you can Blizzard Rail if you want. Alright, and now for the final boss. Oh, goody. This bastard. May your heart be your guiding key. You pray like you have never prayed before, because this guy can screw you up. This fight really sucks. However, I have found a strat that has been the most consistent for me. For the first half, I found a strat that has been consistent for me. And it works. I don't know if it's the best strat, but it's worked for me. So, allow me to walk you through it step by step. That final boss theme, though. The song kicks ass. Alright, so what we're going to do here is, we're just going to go ahead and attack him with physical attacks, because we want to build up Spellweaver. Make sure you air slide after each combo, so that way you'll be closer to him to attack. Okay, alright, you see how he's orange? Once he's orange, shot luck. Maximum shot luck. You want to do this for a reason. You want to shot lock because, you don't want to shot lock for damage. You want to shot lock because this is actually like a manipulation for later on to where Wayfinder will show up guaranteed. So you do want to do that. It's kind of crucial. Okay, after that, after your shot lock, go ahead and turn into Spellweaver and then just start bombarding him with magic. Make sure to alternate between fire and blizzard spells. And then once you're out of magic, just go ahead and attack him with physical attacks. Okay, do your magic finishers, and then attack him. Okay, and then once he turns orange, do your Spellweaver finisher. However, while you are in your Spellweaver finisher, look for those like barrels and boxes that you see in the background. Go for it and attack them. So that way you can refill your MP and maybe your focus gauge too. See, just like that. Now automatically my MP is refilled. And remember how I said how you don't want to attack him during the orange phase because he has heightened defense? Luckily, the Spellweaver finisher ignores defense, so you don't have to worry about that. Okay, and once you're done with Spellweaver, just go ahead and bombard him with a bunch of magic spells like normal. Just bombard him with a bunch of magic spells, don't worry about it. And then once you're done, just bombard him with physical attacks. You don't want to quite use your magic finishers quite yet. You don't want to use them quite yet because you see where his HP is at right now? At some point, he will go into his desperation move phase. And if you use your magic finishes now, it's kind of a waste. It's going to be harder to take him down. So just wait on that for now. Just go ahead and hammer the attack button. Okay, all right, see how he's moving like that? Okay, now he's in his DM phase. Okay, he's right there. All right. Well, first of all, let me use my Mega Ether. Okay, viewers, at this point, here's the best thing I can tell you. Hit him with everything you've got. Everything you've got. With one exception. Do not use a maxed out shot lock. Do not use a maxed out shot lock. If you do, it'll slow you down. Hit him with everything you got. Partial shot locks, magic finishers, wayfinder finishers, magic spells, everything you've got. That's quick, okay? May your heart be your guiding key. Ah, you asshole. Like I said, at this point, hit him with everything you've got. What the hell? Where'd he go? Oh, I was about to say, boy. And there's the final boss. In fact, I think that was actually the best fight I've had, to be honest. Sure, give me the best fight during my tutorial, but not during my runs. Alrighty then, viewers, and congratulations, you have now ended your very first speedrun. Or maybe your, like, 20th speedrun if you're just struggling that much. So, that'll have to do it for this video, viewers. Hopefully I was of some help, hopefully I was clear. Hopefully the game audio wasn't too loud, because this is actually my second time recording this. If you have any questions, please let me know in the comments below. If you want to see a boss fought a certain way, go ahead and request it, and I can make a video of it and show you in great detail how they work. Or you could just watch my previous speedruns. I'm sure maybe that'll answer your questions there. Hopefully this video was of some help to you. Hopefully it'll help you get started speedrunning. Again, if you have any questions, let me know. Alright, that'll have to do it for this video episode. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, don't forget to hammer, smash, and stab that like button, subscribe, of course. And I will see you guys next time. See you guys later. Be safe. Eat that a shy. Don't overdo it.